I work with a lot of people who achieve really big things professionally, financially, starting companies, growing companies. And one thing I've learned is that people can get really, really far in life without really knowing why they've gotten this far. My name is John Clark. I'm a licensed counselor at calmagaincounseling.com. If you're interested in online counseling, just head to calmagaincounseling.com to get started. In this video, we're going to be talking about what I call how to identify your fuel source. So I want to talk to you about this idea of your fuel source. In other words, what drives you to do the things that you do? What drives you more specifically to achieve in life? A couple of years ago, I asked a client who has had a lot of success in their career, what's your fuel source? And they said, to beat the competition, to beat everyone else. And I said, okay, so that's your fuel source for now. It's part of what's gotten you here, right? Is wanting to beat the competition. But what I'm afraid of is that's what I would call dirty fuel. You're running on dirty fuel. Just like a car running on dirty fuel, you can only run on it for so long. At some point, it's not going to be a sustainable fuel source to keep your engine running. So here's a really important distinction with a fuel source. Are you motivated because you're moving toward pleasure, joy, success? Or are you motivated because you're avoiding failure or you want to see the competition lose? This is a really important question to ask yourself as a starting point. As we talked about fuel source, we also came up with this idea that you might be doing really well in one particular area of life, like business, but what about all the other areas? We use an analogy of flying in an airplane and looking at your cockpit, kind of the dashboard in the cockpit. So let's say business success or financial success is one dial in that cockpit. You're doing really well in that one dial. But what about all the others? So we have to look at your life more holistically, and we have to figure out what else is in this dashboard, what other dials are important to me. You're the only person that can do this work, that can actually figure out what's important to me. In other words, if I'm successful, how will I know that I'm successful? What will I be measuring myself by? All right, so if you're interested in all this stuff that I'm talking about and you want to start doing some of this work on your own, here's an exercise for you. All the best companies in the world are driven by three things: mission, vision, and values. It might seem kind of corny to do this for yourself as an individual, but I highly recommend that you go through this exercise of creating your own mission, vision, and values. Here's an example. So mission is kind of the big picture impact that you want to have on the world around you. Part of my personal mission is reducing human suffering in as many people as possible. The vision is kind of how you're going to accomplish that mission. So part of how I accomplish my mission is by doing individual therapy, by doing group therapy, by making free content like this to help people through video. I also help other counselors build their businesses, and by doing that, I'm achieving my mission of reducing suffering in the world. So again, vision is how you're going to accomplish the mission. Your values are really what you believe about how you're going to get there and the decisions you're going to make along the way. Your values are kind of like a filtering device for making decisions. It's extremely important that you try to figure out what's important to you in life, and probably just as important, you need to figure out what's not important in your life. In other words, what are things that you don't value? We're going to put a link in the description below to a values assessment that you can do for free. It's an exercise that if you're in my office, we would sit down on the floor, we would spread out all of these cards, and they have different values on them, things like family or fitness or giving back or creativity or aesthetics. We'd spread out all these cards, and then we would put them into one of three categories: important to me, very important to me, and not important to me at all. You'd be amazed at how quickly you can do this exercise. Even though maybe you've never said your values out loud, I guarantee that you'll find that it's really natural to actually sort through these cards and put them in the right category. If you're doing this exercise, I recommend that in the very important column, which is the most important, you narrow that down to three or no more than five values. Focus on those five values, take a picture of that, put it on the background of your phone, look at it every single day if you want to start living a life that's more values driven. I think one of the biggest mistakes you can make is living an accidental life. So getting clear on your values is going to help you avoid that risk and live life with more purpose starting today. Hope this video was helpful. Again, my name is John Clark. I'm a licensed counselor at CalmAgainCounseling.com. If you want to get started, just head to CalmAgainCounseling.com today and get in touch. Look forward to hearing from you.